Okay, so I opened Unreal Engine 4 and I already made one folder textures, and there are a few ways you can import files. You can drag and drop and import it, but of course you can also go to import. I'll make a new folder here, meshes. I'll open it and I'll press import. I need to go to my desktop. Particles, meshes, finished. And I got a few spare ones left, but there we go. And import them. I already named them, just so import all should be fine. And yes. And I should probably try to move my files. There we go. Move folder here. That's better. Okay. And I also need a folder materials. Why are you starting in meshes? Don't do that. Games, there we go. New folder. And I'm gonna call it materials. So I got the texture done. I'm gonna set some settings. I'm not gonna touch the mipmaps for now. The LUT group is effects. And compression without alpha. Now there are some cases where you don't want to tile the texture, and then there are options like clamp, which will make the edge of a texture repeat endlessly, or mirror, which actually inverts the texture every time. But for now, wrap should be fine. I'm gonna save it. Hopefully it won't take too long. There we go. I'm gonna make a material. First off, I'm gonna make the material for the trail. New material. Trail effect mods. I'm gonna double click on it. Okay, I need a few things here. First of all, I need some of the textures. Well, just the one, because we all combined all of them. The combined RGB. There we go. And I'm gonna need this 4 times. Why? I'll show you later in a bit. There we go. Okay, first of all, like I said in when I was working on Photoshop, we have 3 channels. The red channel, which is the thruster, the green channel, which is the marble texture, and the blue one, which is the cloud effect. And some of those effects we want to have scrolling or panned. So let's do that first. And I'm going to start at the bottom. I'm going to get a panner. There we go. And I'll copy it with Ctrl and W. I'm going to connect the panner to the UVW. And let's see. Start perfume node so you can see what's going on. At the moment, nothing is happening. But then I'm going to change something. I think I'm going to go with -1 and 0.125, because I want a little bit of variation. And as you can see, it's panning now. Okay, I'm going to go with the second one, and I want this to be a bit slow, faster than the other one. So -1.5, and just for a little bit of variation, I'm going to add a Z1 there. That one is panning a little bit faster. Let's show. Okay, but we don't want it to look like this because it's ugly. So let's see. I'm gonna multiply. Hold M and then click, then you get a multiply. And I'm gonna combine the cloud channel with the marble channel and see what the result will be. I'll remove the grid for a bit. I'm gonna make this a little bit bigger. And it's starting to look like something. Let's play with it a little bit more. Let's make an add. You hold down the A button and then click. And let's combine marble with the cloud. And let's see what happens then. Then you get this, which is almost the opposite actually. And it doesn't look too bad. I want these effects to be much more pronounced, so I'm going to multiply them. Let's see, and start reviewing node. And it should be the same, but now if I increase the multiplier by, let's say, 10. And that's really bright. I like it. And just because I already know what I'm going to do, I'll probably have to multiply it later, and the brightness will go down a lot. Let's see if I multiply the multiply by 10, what happens there. I'm combining shaders, and this is a totally different effect. And I also like that one. Let's see what happens when I multiply those two together. Combining shaders, and it looks totally different again. I'm liking the effect. Let's zoom in a bit. Yeah, I like it. So now we got that part done. Let's go to the top two. I had those separate for a reason. The red channel is the tail. I want to do something with that, of course. So let's, I'm gonna explain a bit better. Let's hope. Okay. I want the red channel to be both a mask, so everything that's not inside of it to be invisible. But I also want a little bit of the white that the channel has to go through it, so it looks more pronounced. So I'm gonna start with a multiply. Only the red channel, and this is the result you'll get. There you go. But it's much too bright for now. So, random number 0.05. Oh, it's nice and dark. I want that because later on it will be multiplied with every effect from here, and we don't want it to be too bright. Else only the only thing you'll see is white. Then I got the second one, which I actually don't even need anymore. I'm gonna do another way. Sorry about that. I'm gonna create a second multiply and do it again. Now let's see what happens when I double hit with multiply. Oh, need to preview the node, of course. And again, it's really bright, and as you can see, it's almost hitting the edge. But it just doesn't, and I'm happy with that. Okay. Then I probably want to see how these two look together, the panner effect and the multiply. So let's just add both to see what happens. You can barely see where the tail is, so I'm gonna do something different as well. I'm gonna add another multiply, and let's see what happens when I combine it with this. And this is the result I'm kind of after. I mean, it's a bit wonky still, but it's starting to look much better. Now I want to do something, how do you call it? Make it skip between how dark this one is and how bright this one is. I want to flip it, so to call. So let's use a lerp interpolate. If you hold down L, the L button, and click, you get one as well. And combine these two together. What a lerp basically does, it blends two inputs, the very dark one and the very bright one, through an alpha channel. Basically, if this one is white, only the dark multiply is seen, and if it's black, this multiply I was seeing, or inverted. I'm not sure, but it works. And then I'm gonna get me a sine. A sine is like it goes up and down from 0 to 1 over a period of time. And just like I said, time, I need a time plug node. There we go. I'll plug it in. And let me show you what it does. There we go. Vroom, vroom. It goes on and off. Okay, and I want it to be not exactly 1 second, because it, you know, you will notice it. So let's do something different. Let's go with the lead again. And just to be sure everything goes all right, I'm gonna add a clamp, which basically clamps a value between two. And I don't want it to go to exactly zero. So let's say the max, the minimum clamp is 0.5. It won't go lower than half the brightness. And I'll show you what it does. There, it stays gray. And it only goes to white a little bit. And I'm going to increase the max by 2. It probably won't do anything, but just to be sure. I'm going to multiply that. Okay. Oh, no, not multiply, sorry. I'm gonna combine it to the lerp. And I'll show you what starts happening. There. It's only for a little bit, but it can add a nice touch to it. And I'm gonna attach that lerp to a multiply. And that's this multiply. So there we go. And the result will be, and even though the throbbing, the sine is a little bit less visible, it's there, and it will add something nice to it eventually. And then I'm gonna add that to this add, and let's see what happens. This is just playing around. I'm not even sure what the end result will be. I mean, I know what I want to do, but sometimes it's just nice to play around with a load of adds and multiplies to see what comes up. And let's see, what else are we gonna do? Let's multiply this value, see what happens. I'm gonna move it all a bit there. Yes, another multiply. My math teachers would go crazy. Oh my god, Lewis can multiply. Okay, and let's multiply that with 10 again. And preview the node. It's nice and shiny. Okay. Now let's... There's always something you want to do with particles, and you want to change the color of it. And you can do it in a material, but if you want to have more control over the actual particle, then you want to add a particle color. There it is, particle color. I'm gonna add 2 multiplies. Yes, more multiplies again. And I'm gonna put the top input, which is all the colors, the R, G, and the B value, and multiply with the multiply we had. And then the bottom one is an alpha for transparency and that kind of stuff. I'm gonna make that a separate one. There we go. And I'm gonna set the blend mode to additive and the lighting mode to unlit. There we go. I'm gonna add this multiply to emissive and this to opacity. And let's stop previewing. And this is the result we'll get, which looks much nicer than before. And that's basically all we need to do for the tail. You can actually try and apply it on the, one of the meshes we made. I'll take the regular tail one. Press on the teapot here. And there we go. It's a bit bright, but it's good for what we want to do. As you can see, if I rotate, some sides aren't visible. You just click some random place here and go to two-sided. There we go. And now it's visible on all sides. Okay. I'm gonna save this one. And I'm gonna make two more materials. Okay, onto the second material. This one will be for the small orb I showed you in 3ds Max. And it's basically all the same texture as this, but with a few alterations, which is why I'm not making an instance, but making a copy. And let's call it... Let's be very simple this time. Orb effects mod. And change a few things. The first thing we want to change, change the preview mode. I don't need this texture sample now, so let's just create a regular vector 1, if it's called correctly, okay, and apply it to both the multiplies. And I don't need it to be fully bright, like 0, like 1, but a little bit less. So let's try 0.75. There we go. That's almost the result I want to have. But the blend mode should not be additive, which is something you regularly use for particles, but just opaque, like a regular wall or other surface. The lightning model can be unlit though. And I need something else as well. I want to add a Fresnel. Basically what it will do is add a nice light edge around the object. Let's see if there's the exponent in to be a value of 2, I guess. Just a random guess. Oh, let's make it 10 for to begin with. And I'm gonna multiply that around here, almost at the end. Move these two a little bit and put a multiply here. Okay, and add the Fresnel and then apply it to this multiply, and the opacity one we won't need anymore, so that one can actually go. And as you can see, it's a bit darker and there's this whitish edge around it. Let's lower the value with to about 2. And that's look much better. And I want the white edge also to be a bit more visible. And I can increase this, but it will also change how far white edge goes to the center. I'm sure there's a better way, but I'm gonna multiply it again. And multiply it by 2. And to me it looks a bit better. Okay. The reason why I actually chose the marble texture is for this small edges you see. The white lines and dots, and you can also get it with clouds, but it looks too generated. This looks a bit more random. And it gives more, I don't know. This is just something I feel that looks right. And you can always use a different texture if you want. You might even try a wood texture and see how that result will be. You're the one that's gonna be making this, so be creative, have fun, enjoy what you're making. Okay, that looks nice, but I want to do something cool, and this will take me quite some time to do. I want this orb to, well, the right word would actually be throbbing, and I need the world position offset for that. Let's go to sign, and then remap. This has some extra additional cool stuff to it. So basically it takes value 1 and value 2, which can be just these. If you hold 1 down you get this one, if you hold down 2 you get a factor 2, if you hold down 3 you get a factor 3, and with 4 you also get an alpha channel with it. I won't be needing those. So Come on, delete. There we go. I'll put them in here. Move this a bit up. And the value 1 should be really low. 0.1 should be okay. But this one should be fairly low as well. 0. I have no idea. Just some random number to make it sure that's really hard for them to match up and sync. The result should be. Nothing at the moment. Okay. I can solve that later. And I want another sign remapped. And I'm gonna blend those two in a bit to make it more random, even. And it's already quite random, but. I really like the 3-3 things. That's almost lead. And this one I'm gonna make 0.321. It's a bit random, but the end result should be random as well. And now it needs a sine phase, and that's basically a time, which is this. But there's also another version of time that's called time with speed variable, which is a bit more random. So let's take that. I'm gonna move these ones a bit down. I should really clean up a bit, but okay. I'm gonna need another one. I'll place it here. I wish I could explain really well what it does, but sadly I can't. I just know how what it does. Well, the regular fractal time then. But not the bottom one. And then I'm gonna get a time variable, which is just basically this one, and I need another one. Just director effector once again. And I want the time to be between let's say 3 and another regular thing. There. I'm gonna add those two together. Put this one here. And now the result should be visible. There we go. Oh. It's making a bit of a sine effect, but different than the other one we made before. And I'm actually just gonna put the 3 here into this time with speed variable, and the preview should be this. But now when I combine them, I'm just going to use an add. The result is rather random. It starts to glow faster and then slow, fast, slow, and it's like I said a few times before, it's random, and that's what I want. To be sure it doesn't go over certain values, I'm going to use another clamp. There, and the minimum can be 0 actually, but the maximum should be a little bit higher than 1. Let's go with 2.5. It shouldn't do that much, but it's just to make sure that nothing goes totally off the charts. And it's a little bit more sharp though, and that's fine. Let's see how that looks on the world position offset. Wait, that won't work. I need to know something else even. A vertex normal. Oh, come on. Vertex normal. There we go. Basically this changes where the vertices on a mesh are. At least that's my understanding of it. Another multiply. Move it there. I'll stop previewing, and you can see it move a little bit, but it should be much more, because if you almost can't see it, then all these nodes are rather useless. So yeah, let's multiply one more time. I'm gonna add this one here. this one there. If you hold Alt and click on align, it gets removed. And I'm going to multiply that with 5. And there, you can now definitely see it move. Let's do a bit more over the top. And this really starts to woom woom woom. Okay, I'll move this one to here. And go back to 5. And let's multiply that with the vertex normal. And you can see it's really throbbing now. It's a little bit, but it just adds a bit of energy or unstableness to it, which I really like. I can maybe go a little bit higher. Let's go really over the top. And even higher over the top. Oh my god. Sorry for the epilepsy attacks. Okay, let's go just back to 5 and be done with it. You saw what it did. Okay. That's basically this for the texture. And it's a bit of a mess. I'm not gonna go all the way of cleaning everything up, but I can show you a few neat things still. Select all these and just press the C on your keyboard and you can comment it. You can instantly start writing, so let's call this vertex normal. There we go. You can also change the color if you want. And let's add these and call it clouds and I could just call it cloud. And you can always change it later here. Cloud plus marble. And do this really need anything else? I could call this base. There. You could always, this is really handy, if, especially if more people are working on something, then they can easily see what's where. So I highly suggest you name everything you make. Okay, the orb mod is done. And now I'm gonna make a really quick additional one, new material, and call it GPU trail effect. And I could actually, it's basically all I want is some small dots. And those are for the GPU particles I'll make later. And I could make a texture for it, but you can actually make something like a small dot in Unreal Engine itself. Radial gradients. There we go. And the result of this is an inverted dot. Now I can probably change some settings in here to invert it, but you can also use a 1-, which inverts whatever it's connected to. There we go, and this is already the dot, and it looks nice already, right? It's, I mean, all we need is dot. But I want it to be glowy already, so let's multiply that. And let's multiply with a factor of 10. And we have to preview it, of course. The dots are really small, so when they are about this size, you can see just a small, nice glow. Okay, and then we also need the particle color, because we want to color them in the particle editor. So let's multiply the RGB colors, the base colors, and apply them to the emissive color. Oh, and obviously I need to change. If you click random somewhere here, then you'll get this menu. Make the blend mode additive and the lighting model onlit. Now I'm gonna combine the alpha channel for the translucency, the output, and put in opacity. And the end result is just a small dot. And let's make it two-sided to be sure. Okay. Thinking about the two-sided, I might have to change one little thing, and that's in the orb effect mod. It doesn't have to be two-sided, so you can disable that one. The result will be exactly the same, but it doesn't have to render the texture on both sides, which is what we need because the material isn't translucent. Okay, and that's it for the materials. Let's go to the particle editor.